While Talon Card would arguably reach the highest height of smuggling organizational power later on in the years following the Galactic Civil War, today we're going to be talking about the man who made that possible, in a video request which comes directly from the comments, Jorj Car'das. Although Car'das was introduced in Spectre of the Past in the Hand of Thrawn duology taking place in 19 ABY, or years after the Battle of Yavin, his start as a smuggler is covered in Outbound Flight, which takes place almost 50 years earlier, in 27 BBY. Car'das, like basically everyone we've talked about on the channel so far, was Corellian, and was given his first smuggling job as a member of the crew of the Bargain Hunter, which would often run cargo for the Hutts, along with Maris Ferassi, whom he got along with fairly well, and Captain Dubrak Kento, with whom he clashed regularly. Kento would insist on his own methods for doing things, and any input from Car'das would often result in an angry response from his captain. While running from Praga the Hutt after failing to meet deliveries, Car'das jumped the ship into a gap in the stars without proper navigational data. Upon exiting, the Bargain Hunter learned they were followed by Praga the Hutt, but before Praga could destroy them, Praga was himself destroyed by Commander Thrawn of the Chiss Ascendancy, since they were in the unknown regions. After their rescue, Thrawn took the Bargain Hunter captive, allegedly to ascertain whether the Bargain Hunter and the crew were threats to the Chiss Ascendancy, but also, mainly, to learn what he could about the Republic and get language lessons from Car'das and Ferassi to learn Galactic Basic, the common language of the Republic. Throughout the book Outbound Flight, Thrawn's early relationship with Car'das was used as a foil for that of Car'das and Kento. Where Kento was domineering and often portrayed as selfish and wrong, Thrawn was often interested in the input from and enlightenment of those around him, even though he was portrayed as quite capable on his own. In his attempts to fight the Vagari, which he believed to be a significant threat to those who lived around the Chiss Ascendancy, if not the Chiss themselves, Thrawn often enlisted the help of Car'das, and the two developed a close friendship and working relationship. In the course of doing so, they began working with Palpatine's advisor, Kinmin Doriana, who'd been sent into the unknown regions to stop a project called Outbound Flight, which aimed to explore and colonize the unknown regions, and even other galaxies, which Doriana, as well as Palpatine, explained to Thrawn could be a risk to the galaxy, but I'll do another video covering that later. While working to stop the Vagari, Car'das gained the attention of Doriana as well, who, upon the completion of their work, offered Car'das a position using smuggling as a front to build an information network which would benefit Palpatine. Car'das accepted, and built up his organization over the years, flourishing in the Clone Wars where smugglers were necessary to get both contraband and legitimate necessary supplies past either side. Car'das later went to the Befash system on a smuggling run several years after the declaration of the Empire. He was confronted by a dark Jedi who killed his entire crew except for him. The Jedi had Car'das take him to Dagobah, where Yoda fought the dark Jedi for over a day, eventually winning. Although Car'das had been freed from his captor, he was severely wounded. Yoda healed Car'das, who became convinced that some of Yoda's ability to sense the Force had been transferred into him in the encounter. In his discussion with Talon Card years later in Vision of the Future, Part 2 of the Hand of Thrawn duology, he attributed a large portion of his later success in growing his organization and information network to this transfer. For several more years, he continued to grow this organization, but his experience with the Dark Jedi and Yoda had left him a crueler man than before. His health once again started to fail, the experience with the Dark Jedi still taking its toll on him, and he returned to Dagobah, demanding that Yoda save him once again. Yoda refused his request, saying he needed to conserve his strength to train a new unknown Jedi, some guy named Luke Skywalker, and that Car'das had already wasted the last attempt to save his life through his cruelty and misuse of the gift Yoda had given him. He did suggest, however, that Car'das seek out the Angti monks, who we've done a video on before, saying that they may be able to help him. Before seeking them out, Car'das received a request for help from Thrawn in the book Choices of One, now an Imperial officer in the early phases of setting up his own Empire of the Hand. Car'das, Thrawn said, remained the only person whom Thrawn could fully trust, and he needed Car'das's help fighting an alien warlord named Nuso Esfat, Poln Major, on the border between known and unknown regions of the galaxy. While initially annoyed by the contact, the ailing Car'das recognized it as potentially being his last opportunity to have a positive impact, and he went to aid Thrawn in his defeat of Nuso Esfa. After completing that venture, Car'das abandoned his organization for good and settled on the planet Exicron near the Cathal Rift, where he met with the Angti, who healed him, but also requested he stay to learn about the teachings of the Angti monks. He stayed for 12 years, and then remained on Exocron in heavy contact with the Angti. When Card, who had taken over his operation in his absence, growing it to an even greater height on the foundation that Car'das had built, turned up seeking Car'das's aid in finding information to resolve the Kamaz document crisis, which threatened to tear the New Republic apart, Car'das also revealed he had gained some level of ability to use the Force from the Angti. Although he was never noted as dying in the following two decades of Legends history, his last major appearance came in Survivor's Quest, where he relayed information to Dean Jinsler, brother of a Jedi who had died on outbound flight, that the remains of the project had been found by Voss Park of the Empire of the Hand in the Chiss. He ensured Dean would meet the Chiss delegation, seeking to recover it along with Luke Skywalker and Mara Jade, saying it was to fulfill a promise he had made earlier, after which he disappeared almost entirely from the galaxy, except in the form of vocoders used by the Angti to communicate in Basic using his voice. I hope you've enjoyed this look at Jorj Car'das, one of Timothy Zahn's many important contributions to the Star Wars universe. If you want to know more about him, I suggest reading either Outbound Flight, Choices of One, or the Hand of Thrawn duology, which are the primary sources for this video. As I said at the start, this video topic was suggested from the comments, so if there's anything you'd like to see me cover, please leave those suggestions in the comments as well. If you've enjoyed the video, consider leaving a like or subscribing. Thanks for watching!